Yeah, well, I work out constantly.
Constantly?
Yeah, as I'm now, I'm lifting the desk up and down.
No, you don't work out at all, do you?
Well, can't you tell?
Yeah, I mean,
yeah, it's like I work out with the Nautilus machine. I just carry it on my back.
That's all.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I'm only 40.
Nutrisystem weight
just
loss.
Like Linda Evans. She's
hey, how
only
old
40.
Are you anyway?
I'm about 57.
Oh, really? Come on.
I never divulge. I'm like, I'm kind of, I'm like Linda Evans' age. She's
you're like in your, what are you, 30?
She's a woman who just hit 40 each interview.
Yes.
And just, you know, what it's like being 40. It's been...
She just turned 40.
Yeah, for the past 50 years, she's been 40.
Let me tell you something, Gilbert. You know, the reason that you look so good is because you stay slim. You're slender. You don't have a weight problem.
And I lease cars.
That's right. But Nutrisystem Weight Loss Program, for those of you who have that problem, I notice you eat a very healthy diet.
Very much so. I usually have some eggs, onions, ham.
Yes.
And that kind of cheese.
Yes.
I always order breakfast here.
Well, I don't know why Gilbert doesn't get heavy. He's one of those people, I think, that forgets to eat.
Yes. Yeah.
Yes.
That was very good.
Yes. 718-896-4200. 718-896-4200.
That was a good one. That
you
was
call
a very
Nutrisystem.
Good
do that again?
Gilbert.
Yes.
Oh, okay. Call the Nutrisystem Weight Loss Program right now.
Okay. Hello. Were they the people who were here that last time with that girl in the bikini?
Yes.
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 Yes. Yes. You remember what I'm talking about.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if Gilbert would go to our Super Bowl party. Yeah, he wouldn't be any fun there.
Gilbert, would you go to a Super Bowl party?
No.
Oh.
What is the Super Bowl party?
Well, I throw a party every year, but you wouldn't get off on it.
No, okay. Not, all right,
I
won't
go. Are you a party animal? Do you like bond with men?
Get to bond.
I bond with men?
No, do you like to like do some male bonding every once in a while?
Yeah. I usually
hunting?
Yeah, with like glue.
Yeah.
Just I bond.
Wrong guy to ask. I shouldn't have even thought of
that. Yeah, you shouldn't have even. I'm right. Just
but Scott the engineer is on the Nutrisystem weight loss program and had pizza, sausage pizza last night.
Sausage pizza?
And that's on the weight loss program.
And he's 600 pounds. See, that's the thing they don't tell you.
He lost 30 pounds.
Yeah, 30 pounds he lost.
30 pounds.
30 pounds.
In
looks
seven
fabulous.
Weeks.
In 7 weeks.
In 7 weeks, he seven lost 30 weeks. Pounds in 7 weeks.
Yes.
All right, we're doing the news.
That was good, too.
And what
say
we
that
got,
again.
What do we got left?
Yes.
I got to just barrel through. What are we doing in the news
Well,
here?
Cher is in Page Six today.
Oh, I really missed her.
And they reveal, this is earth-shattering, that she doesn't work out at Jack LaLanne.
Damn!
Hey,
damn!
Where does she work?
She works at this place. Works out at this place called Plus One.
Let me call for her because I don't want to yell at her.
Yeah.
What is the Gary? Give me the number for Plus One gym.
Yes.
And make it snappy.
She doesn't work out at LaLanne's?
No.
No.
So
then
she's a spokeswoman.
And are they still going to keep her as a spokeswoman?
I would imagine.
Or is she going to do no excuses jeans now?
Did you see Moonstruck?
7 times. Just incredible. No.
No, it's pretty good.
Yeah?
Except we recommend it.
Except for Nicolas Cage.
Yeah, it's all about Italians, and Sonny Bono can't get a job.
Exactly.
Yeah.
They couldn't have had Sonny Bono as the love interest?
Yeah.
Huh?
No.
What? Burns and Shriver laugh at us.
Yeah. Sandler and Young.
Yeah.
Have all our albums. That was a good one, too.
Yes?
Yeah, that's a good
yes.
one. That's a more definitive one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, Madonna and John F. Kennedy Jr. Also work out at this place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. So if Cher's not there, I don't know if anybody's ever going to bring us a number, but if Cher's not there, we could ask for one of them.
Hello, let me speak to Cher, John F. Kennedy Jr., or Madonna, quickly.
Yeah. Either one.
Okay.
Hello?
Yes.
Anyway, I thought that was interesting that she works out there. She has a, you know, it's private training.
Hello, is this Cher?
Yes.
Ah, there's the number. And Ron Darling making all the columns today because he's wearing glasses. I didn't know that was a scoop.
Yeah, quick, that is. That's a big quick, news for me.
Call the paper. I'm wearing glasses.
Yeah.
I can't even see out of mine. They're so dark.
Every celebrity gossip column has this thing about Ron Darling sporting specs. Calling Plus One.
Plus One, hi. This is Howard Stern, the radio guy. I'm on the air. So you're on the air.
Okay, hold on a second.
All right, thank you.
Well, obviously, you've gotten through.
I think I got through to Cuba.
This is a very good phone system.
Hello? Hello?
Yes.
Hello?
Yes.
You sound like Gilbert Gottfried.
It's amazing. A lot of people tell me that.
Who is this?
But I work here in an exercise center.
I see.
And from doing too many push-ups, my voice got like this.
Yes.
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 Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Hello?
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. You two are in the same room.
Yes.
Gilbert, come on. You're crazy.
Robin, say yes.
Hello?
On the phone.
Yeah.
Hello?
Hello?
Where did he go?
Hello?
Wait a minute.
Wait a second.
Oh, that's not right. That's not right. You don't.
What kind of a thing is that?
You don't hang up on human beings.
Really?
Especially celebrities.
Yeah, celebrity human beings.
I'll tell my must have got disconnected.
Yeah, oh, okay.
Yeah, hi, it's Howard Stern. I must have gotten disconnected.
And Gilbert Gottfried.
And Gilbert Gottfried. We're on the air? All I want to know is Cher there?
Cher is not there. She left.
Oh, nuts.
We missed her?
Hey, did you hear this? She's trying to sue me. Oh, she said she was going to.
Cher is trying to sue you?
She tried to.
Oh.
Hey, what about John Kennedy Jr.? Is he there?
Oh.
How about Ricky Ricardo?
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Hello?
Hey, Ricky.
All right.
Well, can see that so bit. For that.
See, that guy's going to kill the bit.
He's not going to play.
He doesn't know his lines.
Yes.
At all.
I wrote him a script.
Yeah, and he blew it.
He was supposed to say, hold on, I'll go get him. He was supposed to say, honey, I'm home. All right.
And one other thing I'd like to mention today. This is something that's really bothering.
Uh-huh.
It's an article in the New York Times today.
Yeah.
And it's about, this is going on in our country, under our very noses.
Yeah.
Gilbert.
There are women now donating eggs to other women.
Oh, yes.
They have stories in here about women who don't know each other. One of them wants to get fixed. You know, she doesn't want to have any more kids. Another one can't have any. She's troubled because
like egg of the month
work.
Right.
So as the woman comes in to get sterilized, they take one of her eggs.
Yes.
And they give it to the other woman.
Mm-hmm.
And then she has a baby.
I see. That is horrible.
Then
that,
they have another case written here of two women. One of them who's had several miscarriages. The other who has no eggs of her own. So the one who's had
and that's going to be a new sitcom with Sandy Duncan.
The one who has the miscarriages is donating an egg to the woman who has no eggs of her own.
Yeah.
She will then have a baby, and then she'll do it twice, and she'll give one of the babies back to the woman who gave her the egg.
That's how my mother had me. I never.
What are we doing here?
Gilbert.
Yes.
Like you don't know about this.
No. Quite often, I was in the egg distributing business.
Is that right?
At a hospital.
Uh-huh.
And women would go in, leave off eggs. I'd give them to another woman.
Yes.
It was a whole kind of...
Well, that was you who did that.
Yes. Yeah.
It was like an egg exchange.
And, but see, most of these women would lease these eggs. They didn't buy them, actually.
From DeFeo?
Yeah. They would lease them.
I see.
And they would get a free television.
Well, it's just interesting what medical science is doing.
Mm. You're telling me.
It's that, and there's now... an odorless garlic.
I was always looking for one.
Yes.
So, you know, life is secure. We can all go back to work.
9:34, Robin.
That's 92. What's happening.
There it is. Everything you need to know. Gilbert Gottfried is here.
Yeah.
A very special man.
A very special man.
When we come
Did
back,
you know you were special even
I'm
as a child?
I was nominated for an ACE Award.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, congratulations.
Yeah. What the hell is that?
I have no idea.
Yeah, very good.
It's like cable calls up. They say, these are our biggest awards. So it's
what
like,
is the award for?
You got me.
Comedy special?
Yeah.
Who are you up against?
I think Bill Dana. And I don't know. I think I have no idea who else is up there.
You know. Oh, don't act like you don't know.
I don't know.
You
are worked on
Oh, I think, let me see. I think Butch Patrick.
Don't say you
and,
don't know.
Let me see. Who is? I actually, maybe Robin Williams. He usually is.
Well, he's no good compared to you.
He's nothing.
He's nothing.
He's dirt. He's dirt compared to me. Come on.
Who else could be nominated?
I'm Gary Hart's advisor. What?
I'm just wondering who else could
Sometimes I call up Gary Hart. I go, come on.
All right, listen, we got to take a break. It's 9:35, 92.3 K-Rock, WYSB. We'll be back with Gilbert Gottfried.
Come on.
Who's at Caroline's
Say yes again?
Tomorrow?
Yes.
Yeah.
And tonight?
No, not tonight. I've got a headache.
Tomorrow and Thursday.
Not tonight. I've got a yeast infection.
Tomorrow and Wednesday night.
No, I can't.
That's the new one.
Tomorrow and Wednesday night. But
Caroline's.
Not tonight until I have a list of 8 clubs you've worked at before.
9:36 at 92.3
K-Rock. And whether they were all clean.
And WYSP will be back right after this word.
Hey, life
work. Whether or not Rodney Dangerfield will be successful on Broadway.
Oh, he's doing the Broadway thing.
Yeah.
I'm on my juice diet.
Him and Jackie Mason are swapping roles.
A person of that caliber to do a thing like this, and this is not against you personally. I think you're a very wonderful person, and I think I have the utmost respect for you and everything that you're doing, and this is not meant to put you down as a person or a human being. Let me tell you something, mister. I have nothing against you. I think it's a wonderful job, and it's all the politics, and to someone who is a very intelligent man, a very great man.
But Jackie, what about the fact that you are too Jewish?
I never thought that I was too Jewish. And the first thing about it, I would be the first person to tell you this. This is not against you personally as a human being. I have the utmost respect for you. This way, if I'm putting you down, it's not as you as a person. It's you as something other than a person or as a human being. Or, of course, you, I have the utmost respect for.
It's this guy in the front row you don't have respect for.
Yeah, him I don't have respect for, but you as a human being, I have the utmost.
What about you going on Broadway as Jackie Mason?
I'm planning to go on Broadway as Jackie Mason because I have the utmost respect for as a person and as a human being.
I got to tell you about my bar.
Yes.
I can see that.
I had the utmost respect for them as a human being.
Gilbert as?
Gilbert Gottfried is Jackie Mason.
The Jackie Mason experience.
Be like a tribute.
Yeah, well, he's got the voice down.
And you have his voice down as a person, but not as a human being.
Well, to tell you the truth.
To tell you the truth.
Anyway, you know something?
I have the utmost respect for you.
Yeah.
As a person.
Well, you can just memorize his stuff and go out and do it.
Hey, but tell you the truth.
What about my bar? You, with all your impressions and all your material, Gilbert, don't you have to computerize all that material?
Yes.
Yes.
And, you know, this is not a segue into a commercial.
Yes.
This is actually a conversational.
This is a question.
Well, you know, as a matter of fact, yeah, and I've been trying to find a place where I could get a computer from.
No, listen, in all seriousness,
because I already have a television set because I bought a VMW to get it.
My bar is a special kind of company. You're a smart man.
I don't know if it was as bright a move as I could have. It seemed to have cost me more. I had to buy the
TV. My bar is bigger than your bar. My bar is the company that computerizes businesses, Gilbert, as you know.
And you are a business.
And you are a business.
I am a business.
Yes, I bet you there's a Gilbert Gottfried Incorporated.
Not now. Now I just, all my money goes to the government and they send me what's left.
No. Come
over.
On. You have a corporation, right?
Who does have a corporation? Do you have a corporation?
Of course. Everyone in show business has a corporation.
They all have. I got to call my accountant right now.
No, you have one, of course.
Lefty, and lefty. Yeah.
No, you have one, don't you?
No, I have nothing. I've got zero.
He's one of these comedians that tries to portray himself as the poor man, everyman.
The poor everyman.
He's making $15,000 a night at Caroline's, and he's got no money.
And that's just for lunch.
Yeah. So, and he's going to make $30,000 in 2 nights, in 2 hours worth of work.
But has no corporation.
But that's not anything against Caroline as a person or as a human being. This is something that I pay my personally.
I don't nothing against them, just you.
I just personally
Oh, man. You know, you're not too Jewish, Jackie Mason. You are not.
No, it's not. Because, you know, I saw Gilbert Gottfried still have a corporation, or whether or not he should have a corporation. This is nothing against him personally.
Was Jackie Mason aware that you were in the audience?
Well, he even said to me, he said, you know, I am aware that you're in the audience.
No, was he aware of it?
Yeah, and then in the middle of the show, he said, Gilbert Gottfried's in the audience, and this is not like
a
tickets?
Did you get your tickets from Jackie Mason?
I scrounged my agent.
Oh, you got your agent to get him?
Yeah,
Don't you have Woody Allen's agent and David Letterman's agent?
Oh, no, that's Rollins and Joffe.
Yeah, don't you have them?
No, I don't have them.
Why not?
I don't know. They never called.
Who do you have?
Want to give them
Who's
a call?
You have, ICM or something?
As the old joke goes, I don't have an agent. I'm with William Morris. Ladies, you probably don't know that joke, do you?
So you have William Morris?
Yes. Yes.
And what do you have, like some young guy who's assigned to you?
Well, there's a whole bunch of people, and, you know, you call them up, and they go, well, gee, things are late this time of year. It's just, generally around July, things usually start
picking
up.
So you book your own club dates, and then the guy at William Morris gets the money, gets 10% of the money.
Yeah, once you get your own job, then they call you up and go, is everything doing okay?
Yeah, you know what I find, You know what I find embarrassing about having an agent?
Yeah.
To me, the most embarrassing thing is if you're not making enough money to impress them.
Yes.
You sort of feel like you've got to make a lot of money.
To make him happy.
Yeah, to make them happy, or else you want to look like you're happening in their eyes.
I like when agents call you up and go, so are you working lately?
Yeah, that's a dangerous thing. Let me tell you about my bar, though.
Okay.
What they do is they go into a business, okay, and they say, well, wait a second, inventory, this kind of thing. Okay. These things take time. Okay. What you should be doing is simplifying. Now, you don't know how to work a computer, but they teach you inside of an hour. Because they set up the software, they set up everything. They're on they're your consultants all year round. Yeah. It's my bar. They're fabulous. MIBAR. Find out how simple can be.
Yeah.
Yes, that's my bar.
That's their new slogan.
That's not written down anywhere.
No, I wrote that.
No, you just came up with that?
I made that up.
Yeah, okay.
MIBAR. That's 212-725-4600.
212-725-4600. Look what's here.
My bar.
Look what's here.
Breakfast.
Look what's here. And it's like, I love it.
The thing with Gilbert is when you have him on the show, you have to have breakfast for him.
You have to, because I'm a Jew.
And Jews want some kind of payment for for their work.
So we have to buy Gilbert breakfast.
Once again, a Howard Stern anti-Semitic remark.
That's exactly.
You're getting famous for on the air.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Isn't that unusual?
Yeah. It's because we ran out of black material. Well, it's time to go to the phones.
Yes.
Yes.
Because Gilbert's eating, I'll have to do his part.
Yes.
Hi, who's this?
Gilbert. Hi, it's Howard.
Hi, it's the Barry Gray Show.
Is this Howard?
We're going to put you on the air in a few minutes.
It's Barry Gray Show, so we're all going to yell now.
Yeah.
Just,
can you hold on, please?
Welcome to WMCA, Barry Gray Show.
Sue?
Yeah, can you hold on?
Yeah, I'm holding on.
All right, let's put you on hold.
Let's
hold on. We'll get back to her. Hello?
Hi.
Hi, can you hold on, please?
Sure.
Okay.
I'll put him on hold. Hello?
Yeah,
can you hold on, please?
Hi.
Oh, boy.
Hello? Hold on.
He's holding.
Let me get back to number one. You're still holding, right?
Hi, yeah.
All right, hold on.
Okay, just hold on there.
Hello?
Hi, Howard.
Yes, please hold.
Yeah, can you just hold on, please?
Thank you.
You're holding, right?
Yeah.
Hold on.
Yeah, hold on.
And you're holding?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on.
Okay.
And you're still holding?
No.
Oh, hold on anyway.
Hold on. Hello? Okay. Hello?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Hold on, please.
Okay.
Who are you calling for?
Howard.
All right, hold on.
Okay, hold on, please.
Hello?
Hello.
Are you still holding?
Yes.
Hold on.
Are you holding?
Yeah.
All right, hold on.
Hold on, please.
Thank you. Love you.
Hold on.
Bye.
Why did he say bye? He was supposed to hold.
No, don't go. Just hold on, okay?
Just.
Got it.
All right.
Okay, hold on.
All right, we'll be back with more phone callers right after these words. Hold on, everybody.
Hold on.
All right. Hold on, we'll get to you right after these words.
Okay.
Okay, just hold. Just
hold on.
Please hold, please.
Yes.
All right, listen to this. Listen to this.
Yeah. Really fancy radio show where they go all out for you. They will bring you a human fetus thing.
Human fetus
and a little packet of ketchup.
Yeah, well, we're a low budget. If we only have chicken eggs.
Yeah.
Sure, on TV you get human eggs.
Yeah, they bring us human fetuses in tinfoil.
Hold on a second. I do have a problem here.
What?
Are you still holding?
Are you holding?
Yes, I am.
All right, please
hold on.
Okay.
And you are still holding?
Yeah.
Hold on.
What about you? Are you holding?
Yeah.
Be patient.
You're holding?
Hold on, please.
Hold on. And you're still holding, right?
Yeah, I'm still holding.
Make sure to hold.
What's the story?
Just hold on, please.
We're getting to the
Hold on, please.
Next. All right.
We'll be getting to you right away.
You'll be in this next segment.
Okay.
And you are still holding? Okay. There we go.
If you'd like to call in...
What is the number
here? We still have plenty... What is the number here?
I can't believe you put ketchup on your eggs.
Well,
you're like Jackie O. My goodness.
Does she do that?
I don't think they're unhealthy enough on their own.
Well, he wants to have a vegetable
Because a person who has eggs in the morning, this is something that I tell you personally. A person like that, who has eggs,
and the way you eat and stuff, you don't get sick a lot?
Right now, I have brain cancer.
I see.
Yeah.
Well, you can have 3/4 of that removed.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Still function,
and
evidently.
In fact, you'll get more work.
Yeah.
Her agent is so thrilled she had her tongue removed.
You didn't know that was a career move.
Daniel Rogers is the place that grows hair. Now, Gilbert, you don't have this problem. You have hair on your head, and you look fabulous. By
no, I have just hair on every other part of my body.
No, you have a nice head of hair.
Thanks.
I bet your women are very attracted to your
hair. They want it.
They love it.
They want it.
Yeah, no, seriously.
Yeah, when I was here with Meg Griffith, that was the deciding vote.
Yes, that Meg Griffith.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, let me just tell you something. Daniel Rogers, that is such a good place. I mean, they're such good people. First of all, let me tell you what they do. They take a bald man.
Yeah.
In fact, I don't know if you saw this, but the woman at Daniel Rogers was on our show for the birthday show, and she actually saw Grandpa Al Lewis from the Munsters and said that she could grow hair on his head. And he is as bald as anyone could be.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
Yes.
He's been bald a long time.
Now, that is amazing. I thought once a guy goes bald for a long time, you couldn't grow hair, but no.
Yvonne DiCarlo is bald, which you people know.
Yes.
The whole cast of the Munsters
is bald.
I didn't
know.
Except for Lily.
Yeah.
All right, anyway, Daniel Rogers is so revolutionary that what they have done, literally, and I know this sounds too good to be true, but at least try.
I wouldn't lie because I own the company.
No, wait a second. They have an herbal formula, okay? And I admit that this sounds weird, but they rub it in your head, and then in a month you should see hair growth. And if you don't, they'll give you your money back. Now, they're willing to give you your money back.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Will they just give me my money without me rubbing it in?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Can I just call them up and get money?
She's amazing. She can grow anything, this lady from Daniel Rogers. In fact, she could grow, you know those eggs you're eating?
Yeah.
She could grow those into chickens.
Oh, boy.
Yes.
All right. Think of
that. Dial.
Had I known that before, I would have had a chicken dinner.
Dial 212.
Now you tell me.
Let me give you the phone number right now. And also, they have all kinds of special offers.
Robin, quick, say yes.
Yes.
Okay.
All I know is that when someone says they will grow hair on your head or give you your money back, then I trust them. And I will give you the number right now, Gilbert. 212.
212-686-5977.
You know, Robin, the whole show's gone by, and I feel like I haven't gotten to anything.
We did get to a lot of things today.
Seven. We did.
He's still trying to get the number. But we did. Six. We talked about a lot of things today.
I mentioned what a dildo John Gambling Jr. is, right?
Yes, yes.
I mentioned the...
We mentioned the Super Bowl...
mentioned the Super Bowl party.
Yesterday, and the party we started to plan...
We'll do more of that tomorrow.
Yeah.
Tomorrow I'll be talking about what I'll be doing on Letterman.
Right. We didn't get to call...
Did you call KKK?
Letterman people.
Gilbert wants me to call the KKK hotline.
I figure the show is...
can't you make that call on your own?
No.
Like you never do.
You know, do we have to call them here?
Hi, Robin.
Yes.
Are you holding?
Are you holding?
Yes, I am. Who's this, Robin?
Yeah?
Yes.
Howard.
Yeah. Yes.
Hi, it's Robin.
Robin. No, get that. Is it Gary?
No, it's Robin.
Robin?
Yeah.
It doesn't sound like Robin.
Yeah, it is. I've been eating eggs.
She sounds different on the phone.
Change my
Howard. Yeah. I want to come to New Year's party. I love my parties.
You love what parties?
Football party.
Football
party? No, there's no women allowed. It's just
Why not?
It's a man's party.
I'll come naked.
No, if we have women...
How about if I wear a bow? A ribbon?
No, if we have women, it's going to be like professional strippers.
Oh, come on. My name is Summer. I work in Jersey. I'm from Asbury Park.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that changes it.
Why didn't you just say that to begin with?
So I didn't know.
Oh, Summer.
Personal friend of Bruce.
Her name is Summer.
Her name is Summer?
Fall and winter.
Fall and winter are her brothers.
Hi, Robin.
Hey, listen, I got to move along. We're going to call the KKK hotline.
Oh, who is this? Howard?
No.
No, it's Robin.
It's Robin.
It's Robin.
My voice changes cracking.
Robin.
Yes.
Robin.
I love to suck Howard Stern.
Oh, whoa.
Hold on. Can you hold for Howard Stern?
Could you hold on, please?
Yes.
Please hold. Hello?
Yeah.
Are you holding?
This is Tyrone. I'm calling about the stuff you said about Martin Luther.
Oh, get out of here.
Hey, that's an excellent black impression.
It really is.
Really?
I was very impressed.
I like the stuff you've been saying, man.
Martin Luther?
At one point, I even said, my goodness, he's black.
Yes.
The man was legend in his own mind.
I don't think that's someone doing a black imitation. I think that's actually a black person on the air.
I'm from New Jersey, man. I don't like the stuff you've been saying about him.
All right, can you hold on?
All right.
I'll put you through to Howard.
We should run up his bill.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yes.
Hi.
Yes.
Yeah.
Could you play the I Choked Lucy for Gilbert and he could tell you how unfunny it really is?
Oh, screw off.
It stinks.
It does not.
Oh, come on. The voices were terrible. He kept using the same joke about the choking Lucy. I mean,
so don't listen.
What do you mean? I don't listen.
Don't listen.
I love a critic. I love a critic.
The
morning.
We did the I Choke Lucy bit. Everyone loved it. And then one guy has to call in like he's superior and it sucked. I realize it's sophomoric and stuff, but that's what people like.
Had he called up and done a black accent, then maybe we would have listened to him.
Exactly. Yes.
Good morning.
Yes.
How are you?
Yes.
That's good.
Come on, let's talk.
Hurry up, we have to make some anti-Semitic remarks.
Oh, I haven't made one in 3 minutes.
Yes, please.
I'd be into that.
You'd be into that.
Oh, sure.
All right, let's call the KKK hotline and put you... Oh, let me tell them to stay on hold. Stay on hold,
they
we'll put you through to Howard.
They must be having...
Hold on, okay?
I'll hold.
All right. Are you there? Are you there?
Yeah, I'm still here.
And you're holding?
You are holding.
Yeah, I'm holding over here. I'm on a payphone. What are you doing?
All right, what do you want?
I want to ask you a question about the pay-per-view. A friend of mine wants to...
A what?
Pay-per-view?
What is pay-per-view?
I have no clue.
Go ahead.
Then how can you ask questions about something you don't know about?
First of all, watch Letterman tomorrow night. I'll be discussing my pay-per-view special.
Oh, pay-per-view. I thought it was pay-per-view.
Watch Letterman tomorrow night and everything...
It's costing me $100 over here. I'm holding.
Everything will be very clear.
So hold on, please.
Everything will be clear after tomorrow.
Everything will be revealed to you, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
So Lucy was beautiful. I can't believe that guy on the phone before.
Well, some people just have no sense of humor, sir. You know, when you do jokes about people being stuffed into a garbage bag...
Some people don't see the humor.
Oh,
that's
man,
right.
That's cold.
Yes. All right, dude.
All right, thanks a lot.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
I heard that the cable systems have 600,000 families now hooked, ready to go for the cable special.
I still haven't called.
Yeah, well, you have no problem. You can hook right in at any time.
Yeah, but I want to make sure to do that.
We might just have all our audience go over to your apartment and watch the special, since you're the only one who can get it. I'm doing a pay-per-view thing on cable.
It's a pay-per-view?
Pay-per-view.
So this is, you call up and you give them money and...
Right.
Yeah.
And this way I have no network censorship and I have no network to deal with.
And you have no network.
And I have no network. My own network.
You have no show.
Oh, this is a show.
Yeah.
So Howard Stern underpants and lingerie party.
Ah.
Everyone there is going to be in their lingerie and underpants.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Robin, like, you're going to be there?
Maybe he has not been nominated for an ACE award.
Right.
No. Show.
It's a pretty prestigious award, that ACE award.
Yeah. I don't think I'll be winning any ACE awards for this one.
And this is not against you as a person. This is just means that as an ACE award.
You mean you personally don't
like
it?
Not against me personally.
Yeah, right.
I don't like this.
Okay. Now, it's 2:02. I could either finish off the show by calling the KKK hotline.
I mean, this is a perfect day to call. They must be incensed today.
For Martin Luther? I bet you they get a good Martin Luther.
Oh, yes.
Holiday.
Yes, they
for
must.
Martin Luther King.
While
come
I'm
on.
Dialing, we could listen to
And them. Now David Brenner will be at, hi, it's KKK hotline. Hi, I'm David Brenner. You know what burnt me up about black people?
What's that?
You know what burnt me up?
Yeah, what is that?
That's really burnt me up. You know what burnt me up about Jews and black people, ladies and gentlemen? You know, I really think that black people are lazy and they cause crime and that Jews own most of the nation's wealth, ladies and gentlemen. You know, it really burnt me up. Hi, it's David Brenner for KKK hotline.
Hey, whatever happened to David Brenner? He used to be a friend of ours.
He's, Valmano split from the scene.
Yeah, he does not like hanging with us anymore.
I have not had a return of a call from him. We tried to call him for the birthday show. I figured, hey, why not?
Yeah.
Because he hasn't been around for a while, but apparently Gary could not get a hold of him.
Gary, bring me in David Brenner's manager friend, his phone number. Let's find out what the real reason is Brenner's avoiding us. Because
yeah.
I saw him on all kinds of dopey shows. Like the morning show. I saw you on Regis. I didn't see you.
You didn't?
I saw you promoed.
Oh.
I can't see, obviously.
Oh, you had to work.
How did that go?
It was great.
How do you relate to that guy?
It was great. I love morning shows. Any kind of morning program.
So what happens,
Marriott,
you go on
Hartley.
There, and does he get it? Does he get the joke?
They don't even get your breakfast on that show.
Really?
No,
but
no.
They have bagels and stuff in the
Yeah,
room.
Like that, they've been there since.
What is,
no. Hi, David Brenner for KKK Hotline. Today I'll be talking about Mexicans. You know, I hate Mexicans. I tell you, they really burn me up, ladies and gentlemen.
Tell me that is probably the best impression ever of anybody.
It's very good. You never hear anybody doing Brenner.
And Gilbert's one of those guys that'll do it in his act and then just throw it away. He won't keep it in his act.
Oh, no. He'll let that go.
Yes. He'll just let gems go. That's why other comedians are jealous of Gilbert.
Well, they're picking it up. They're saying, hey, Gilbert dropped it. I'll take it.
That's what I read in all the articles about you anyway. Gilbert will just throw that away.
He'll throw it away.
Before we get to the KKK line, I just out of curiosity... Let's call Brenner's...
What?
Agent.
Hi, I'm David Brenner's agent. You know what burns me up?
What is it, Gary?
He may not be around because I've been trying to call them. I tried to get him to your birthday party, and I think they're out of the country.
Oh, maybe that's it. But I just saw him on some show, Brenner, or promoed on some show. Like Regis or something.
Yeah.
I would never do a show like that.
Never. Gilbert's a whore. He'll pretty much do anything.
Anything.
Hello?
Hey, Steve!
Yeah?
It's Howard Stern. You're on the air.
Am I really?
Yeah.
Oh, how are you, Howard?
Well, what's the deal? How come David's avoiding us?
We just got back today.
Yeah, but
that's
come on.
Sunday night. Seriously. We were in the Caribbean for 2 weeks.
Hey, what's with you guys? Brenner made that much money that he can just take off into the Caribbean? You know how much money
he's not a radio DJ, Howard.
Yeah, I know. Tell me about it. David Brenner has like millions of dollars.
I know.
I've seen all his apartments and stuff. He owns whole buildings.
You haven't seen all of them. You just saw one.
I saw the one across the street,
right,
too.
Oh, okay.
Well, that's why he doesn't worry.
Man.
He's invested.
That's right.
And you know, Gilbert, you can do all... Hold, David's right here, Steve. Hold on. He wants to talk to you. Go ahead.
Hi. Steve. Steve. I'm wondering, you know, I have to tape some more KKK hotline. Now, should I ask, do I have to get paid for each one of them, or is it like a package deal?
Tell me that isn't great.
Gilbert does the best one.
Yeah.
He does.
Not
that many people do them, but Gilbert does the best.
As opposed to, like, Frank Gorshin's David Brenner, I mean...
Well, actually...
This guy Steve has the best job in the world. He hangs out with David Brenner. And just goes to, like, the Caribbean and stuff with him.
With him.
Hey, let's go to the Caribbean, okay, Steve? Come on. We'll go to the Caribbean. I mean some money off the KKK hotline, voiceover.
Meet some girls.
We'll meet some girls. Come on. Come on.
Come on. Be fun.
It'll be lots of fun.
What a life.
What a life.
When are you going to invite David back on the show?
What?
When are you going to invite David back on the show?
We've been inviting him.
All right.
We want to find out about what happened with the girlfriend.
Well, let's do it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Okay.
All right.
He dumped that beautiful girlfriend?
We'll do it this week.
Is he out of his mind? That one was perfect.
Steve would just like to say he is not a spokesman for...
Thank you, Robin.
I'm not a spokesman for CBS. These are just the views of Jimmy the Greek Snyder.
Right.
Isn't it Jimmy the Greek Snyder?
Yes.
Yes.
Isn't that a Jew name?
A Jew.
Isn't he part of that whole conspiracy, that whole broadcast conspiracy?
I think so.
Well, you know, they own the networks.
Don't they?
Yeah.
Don't they control the New York Times? Who publishes the New York Times?
It's Jews.
Jews. That's what I thought.
You know who runs the Vatican? The Jews.
And don't they buy up farmland in the Midwest and rob people of their lands?
Yes.
Yes.
Jews.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. You know.
You know what burns me up
about the Jews?
You know, the Jews have owned the Vatican for the longest time now. It's been a Jew conspiracy.
Well, look who manages David Brenner, who appears on network television regularly. A Jew.
I knew it.
It's true.
Steve is a Jew. Did I mention that?
No, you didn't. I didn't know that.
Did I mention the word Jew in the last 3 seconds? Steve.
Yes.
Yes, we have to line that up.
Okay, right.
What
really?
Happened?
We'd love to see David.
So you guys just went to the Caribbean?
Yes.
Oh.
How about if we tell you about it on the air?
All right.
All right?
Okay, man.
Okay. Now you have to tell us now.
No, Gilbert.
No, tell us now.
You tell us in David's voice.
What would David say?
Oh, I was just wondering. I was lying out there.
Well, then you don't have to come on.
I'm lying out there on the beach in the Caribbean. Oh, I had a wonderful time with Steve. Oh, boy.
You know what Jimmy the Greek said about David's old girlfriend?
She was bred for stooping.
Oh, dear.
At least by me. I wish I had her. Where is she? If he dumped her, I want her.
Is she still in town?
I'll marry her. My wife and I'll marry her.
There you go.
You know, maybe we can effect a reconciliation or something.
You can convert to Mormonism, Howard.
Boy, I swear to God, Brenner, as soon as a woman
I'll give her a BMW and a TV.
As soon as a woman gets too close to him, right away.
Boom.
Boom. Boom.
Just
the minute a person gets that close to David Brenner, who's a wonderful human being, I'm not putting him down as a person.
Well, he has a short attention span.
I'm not putting him down as a person.
What is it, Steve, that David just loves women so much?
I think that's not a bad trait, is it?
No.
All right.
But I think at this point...
Hey, it's time to settle down, don't you think?
Isn't he afraid of AIDS and stuff?
Or does he have the girls?
I bet she has the girls tested.
Oh, yeah, I bet. David Brenner could demand that.
Or you can give him the sniff test like I do.
Oh, dear.
No AIDS. I don't smell any AIDS there. Because David and I both have sensitive noses.
Yeah.
I get my flashlight and I examine them.
With a magnifying glass.
Yes. No glass. I just smell. Nope, no AIDS virus. Okay, you're mine.
Well, you have to look, Howard. You have to make sure.
I know a guy who literally checks girls for herpes with a flashlight. before he goes to bed with him. I swear to God. And he's such a rich guy that he gets away with it. Oh, yes, Steve. Well, Steve, I was talking about you.
It's amazing to me, too, Steve. It is. It's amazing to me.
And the man I'm talking about is Steve, David Brenner's agent. Manager, excuse me.
If he had more money, he could check him out with a lit match.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wait a minute. Wasn't there some guy who used to have a doctor around?
Used to have a doctor around?
Elvis.
To check his women? Was that Elvis?
No, I don't think it was Elvis.
No, there was a guy, somebody I was reading about.
That was David Brenner, I didn't know.
So we'll see you this week?
Yeah. Oh, should I have Gary call you?
Yeah.
Oh, dynamite. That's great. I've been waiting to talk to David.
Okay.
Because he's been doing some interesting things.
Yep. And we'll tell you all about him.
All right.
What, go out on a boat in the Caribbean?
Yep.
Well, he owns a boat, doesn't he?
Well, not anymore, but this one, chartered one.
You chartered a boat.
You'll hear all about it, Howard.
Man, if my wife would let me, I would just go with these guys for 2 weeks, you know, take a vacation and go.
Oh, I don't see why she wouldn't let you.
Yeah, I don't see why she wouldn't let you either.
What do you guys do, bring girls with you?
Howard.
No, really, come on, just tell me that. What do? You bring girls with you, or you just go out there yourselves and wait for some girls?
No. It was, basically...
Gilbert, you got to start doing stuff like this. You're making money.
I know.
You know, you got to play Vegas. That's where the money is.
I should.
Yes. Isn't that where the money is, Steve?
That's a lot of money is, yes.
And Atlantic City, right?
And Atlantic City.
Yeah, Gilbert.
And Gilbert knows it.
Get
I know. But Gilbert,
train.
I think Gilbert is like too, you know, he's too hip for Atlantic City. He won't go there on principle.
If they paid me enough, I'd lose they're some of the hipness. I'd be willing to lose some hipness. What the hell?
I mean, my goodness.
There is a price to everyone's hipness, Howard.
No, Gilbert's one of these guys, I can tell, you know.
A purist.
He's a purist. He has to play Carolines for 15 a night.
No, just give me a few bucks. I'll be there. I'll lose some of the purity.
Hmm. You guys get a lot of Tukey on that boat? Tap the phone once for yes. You don't have to say anything. There it is. Did you hear it? Okay, I gotta go, Steve.
All right,
I can't stay on the phone all day.
Okay.
Can I put you on hold?
Sure.
No.
No, I won't put you on hold.
Okay. All right,
Steve.
See you
bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
We should put him on hold for a while. See how he likes it.
Well, he can afford it. He wouldn't care.
That's it. Well, Gilbert, let me say, first of all, you're going to be at Caroline's.
Yeah.
No KKK hotline?
Oh, all right, for Gilbert. Just for Gilbert.
All right.
In honor of Martin Luther King's birthday.
Yeah.
To show you how little Martin Luther King's impact had on us.
I'm telling you. These people weren't changed one bit.
No.
Get some speeches going.
It is something that runs the whole...
You got that phone number?
Gamut of life.
They didn't give you the number?
I got it somewhere.
And so before we condemn them...
This is a beautiful piece.
Let
this is
us
like,
see that we all have...
It's like the end of the Cosby Show.
Yes. You just sit there, have the whole family sit there and listen to this.
Now, you know Cosby.
Oh, yeah.
He forgives Jimmy the Greek.
He forgives Jimmy?
Yeah.
Big of
Jimmy. You see, I forgive Jimmy the Greek for everything that he's done.
Wasn't he supposed to call in, Cosby?
Yes, he was.
To speak to Gilbert?
Oh.
Hello, Howard. I'd like to talk to Gilbert Godfrey, please. It's not against him as a person. I have the utmost respect for him.
Now, what, is Cosby doing Mason's act?
Hey, you know, you can't mix those guys together. Sacrilege in comedy. Hey, what is, Gilbert, you would know, what is Elaine Boozler's three rules of comedy? One is I know you don't sweat in front of the audience.
Never let them see you sweat.
Yeah.
And never be examined with a flashlight.
That's what it was.
The other one.
Ah.
Yeah.
You know, I've been in comedy for a while, and I've got three rules of comedy. One, don't let them hear my act.
That's one.
And number two, don't trade your eggs at a clinic. And number three, don't let them see you sweat. Do you really know those three rules of comedy? See, that's why you don't get the big money.
I know.
Gilbert, is there any reason you really don't do Vegas? I mean, why?
No one ever asked me.
Oh, Gilbert.
Oh, come on.
Where's they call me up and go, "Hi, I'm Gilbert Godfrey. Can I do Vegas, please?" Okay. Okay.
You got to go,
Mr. Godfrey.
You got to get on Carson.
I know.
Carson. Once you get on Carson.
That seems to be the entree.
I want
to
get on Arsenio Hall.
Yeah, but wait a second. I know a guy who went on Carson and nothing happened to him.
Who's that?
Jackie, who's that guy with the bug eyes? The comic with the bug eyes?
Dennis Wolfberg.
Dennis Wolfberg.
Well, he did it again. He did it a second time.
Yeah, but he never gets to go to Vegas.
As a matter of fact, I think he does play Vegas.
Yeah?
But, you know, as an opening act. Doesn't...
Some guys it doesn't. For some reason, Brenner went on and then, like, was making millions of dollars.
Well,
the next
I
day.
Know for sure that, you know, it certainly helped Gary Shandling and Bill Maher and all those guys.
Some guys jump right to headliners and some guys just, you know,
Some guys don't. Yeah. I filled in the blank.
Well,
Jackie, you want to tell us about the guys who don't?
No, I know too well.
Hey, he had lines.
All right, we're calling what? KKK?
Oh, I was supposed to be playing Martin Luther. Martin Lex Luther.
It's a shame we can't call them personally and play this for them.
To achieve distinction.
Yeah.
But that's Martin Luther King hotline.
Lead.
I can't dial and listen to Martin Luther King at the same time.
No, I see. You're being very distracted.
I got, like, totally freaked out.
This is why he was a great orator. Nobody could do anything but listen to him.
I feel like you're putting Martin Luther King on hold.
Yes.
Hi, Martin. Can you hold on, please?
Can you hold, please?
Yeah. Okay.
You're dead. You can hold.
Oh, dear.
Oh, there he is.
Was this it?
What's happening?
This should be the KKK. And then I think Bill Cosby's calling in to speak to you.
Oh, okay. Oh,
KKK's busy.
I think Bill Cosby forgives the KKK.
Yeah, it's funny how many black people are forgiving Jimmy the Greek.
Jesse Jackson.
But I think
Bill Cosby.
Church is going to write a letter for Jimmy the Greek.
Oh, here's the three rules of comedy. I've got those. Never let the heckler get the last laugh.
Uh-huh.
Never follow a cardigan than...
What?
Never follow... Oh, a comedian better than yourself. Boy, this is some handwriting. Another KKK number busy.
I think that the lines are burning up today. They need support.
It's just Martin Luther King holiday.
Yeah, this is a bad day for them.
It keeps everybody calling.
Well, ever since David Brenner took over the hotline, it's really been lighting up.
Yes.
Who wrote these numbers? Mitch? You should see the handwriting here.
Beginning to worry?
I think I'm calling the phone to Jackie Mason.
Well, it's not against you personally.
Jackie Mason hotline.
Hi, Jackie Mason hotline. It's not against you personally.
All right, we got to ring it. Oh, no.
You know, Gary, if you were smart, you'd get Gilbert to cut some IDs as Jackie Mason. Say, hi, this is Gilbert Gottfried, Jackie Mason. I want to tell you that Howard Stern show. You don't let a man like this walk out.
I'm sorry.
You don't let a man like this come in. But I got to tell you something, ladies and gentlemen.
I'll try one more time, Gilbert.
Because all the lines are busy, Gilbert. No wonder you wanted us to call.
Do you have Robert Chambers' number?
Yes, I do.
Yeah, you do? Let's give him a call.
He hasn't been dating much.
No.
He's trying to get Brenda's old girlfriend. It's impossible to get a date when every day they hassle you in the newspaper.
What are the three rules of Robert Chambers?
Don't choke my genitals.
Don't let him see you sweat is the last one.
And never take a date to Central Park.
He's doing a band commercial. Hi, Robert Chambers. There are three rules of rape.
Make sure you have a written permission from a priest.
No.
Oh, boy. Well, I guess we're not going to do this.
This is a busy day for them.
Yes,
well, maybe, I'm telling you, the phones are going nuts with this Martin Luther King. Yeah. Those Southern crackers really need someone to call. Hey, well, maybe Cosby will call in right before you leave here. Cosby?
Okay, we're waiting.
Hello?
You just call them on the radio and they phone in, Howard?
Hello?
Hello?
Is Bill Cosby going to call?
Hello?
Well, because he wanted to forgive.
Hello? Hello?
Well, while we're sitting here, I just wanted to mention that Cheryl Pearson will be coming home tomorrow. I'm sure everybody's going to be happy about that.
Well, we're invited, aren't we?
Yes, I think we should be there for the homecoming. Cheryl, of course, is a girl who paid somebody to knock off her father.
There's someone you want to be in a room with. There's a girl who won't be dating for a while.
And they're saying here she lost 15 pounds while she was in prison.
Oh, that's good.
Because she was depressed.
By the way, I've just been handed the rules of the Robert Chambers rape.
Oh, yeah?
Here's one, number one. Robert Chambers' rule of dating, wear a metal jock. Number two, never date a girl stronger than you. And three, bring a hefty bag.
Oh, dear.
Bill?
Hey!
Yeah?
Hey! Hey, hey! Hello!
Hey, Bill.
Yes?
Gilbert Gottfried's here, who you've worked with.
Hey, hey, is that Gilbert Gottfried?
Gilbert, speak!
Well,
hey!
I made a fact against you personally.
No, hey! Speak up!
What do? You forgive? What's his name?
Jimmy the Greek! Hey, look, I'm ticked off at all the vicious, sick, twisted lies. I mean, black people, we were not bred for sports, Art.
Right.
I look at Jimmy J.J. Walker.
Right, he was not bred for sports.
No,
that's an
he's a colorized Karen Carpenter, Howard.
Oh, that's
no.
right.
I mean, look at the little kid from my show, Rudy.
Rudy, yes.
The little kid, Keisha and I play him.
Yes.
You know, if you sent her into a Jets locker room, you'd find bigger dingleberries on Mark Gastineau.
Oh.
By the way, Howard.
Yes.
I'd like to take this time right now to say, fight heart disease, kidney disease, and blindness. Support the American Diabetes Association.
All right, thank you.
Thank you. I just made $100,000, which just goes to show you I'm still a bigger whore than Bob Hope.
All right, goodbye.
Goodbye.
He's great.
I was wondering about that.
He likes you, I can tell.
Yeah, yeah, I could tell.
He's a lot like Barry Gray, yells into the microphone. Yeah. Well, obviously that was not Bill Cosby.
No,
you
damn.
You sure?
Damn, it really had me going for a while.
I just want to make sure Cher doesn't sue me, so I got to say that.
Darn.
Okay, now it's time to leave. I want to say that Gilbert Gottfried, if you want to see perhaps the funniest man in show business.
Second funniest.
To?
Yeah.
To who?
I don't know.
Well, he's the...
Anybody.
He's incredible, and you should go see him at Caroline's.
And this is nothing against Gilbert Gottfried as a person.
Tomorrow night, you'll be there?
Tomorrow night and Wednesday night.
Wednesday night.
Against him as a person.
Right.
I think he's a wonderful human being.
I got you.
Tomorrow night and Wednesday night.
Yes.
Gilbert
not
Gottfried.
Against him personally.
Caroline's downtown or at the Seaport?
This is at the Seaport. This is not against the Seaport as a location.
And Jackie the Joke Man Martling.
Jackie the Joke Man Martling will be at the Caroline's at the Seaport.
Next Tuesday, January 26th.
This is nothing against him.
Oh, at what? Rascals in West Orange, New Jersey.
He'll be at Rascals. Jackie the Joke Man Motley will be at Rascals. This is nothing against him as a person. What time, what date is Jackie the Joke Man?
January 26th.
He'll be there January 26th.
What is it, Gary?
And Gilbert Gottfried will be at Carolyn.
And it's going to be one of your best appearances, right?
What? One of my second best appearances?
What would you like to hear, Gilbert, as we leave?
What do you got?
Gilbert, what kind of music do you listen to?
I want to make sure Gilbert's okay, man. You all right, man?
Yeah.
Seriously, everything's going okay?
I'm happening.
You're happy?
Yeah, I'm really happening.
That's all I care about, man.
Yeah.
Good friends, good...
Yeah.
Good times.
Yeah.
Everybody happy.
Yeah, everybody.
Because you're a super talent.
Yeah.
And,
Yeah, well, you know, I think I'm a survivor, you know? I think of myself as a survivor.
Yes.
And,
Yes.
And even though they changed my character on my last sitcom...
Yes.
It didn't really stop me, because, I felt I had to march onward, because I've had hard times in my life, and,
Yes.
It's the nature of the business.
Every single person in my family was an alcoholic. Even everybody who knows my family is an alcoholic.
That.
Yes, but I overcame it.
Yes. Yes. Yeah.
In fact, anyone who sat with my family for 3 minutes is an alcoholic. Every human being I've met in my life is an alcoholic.
So they changed the character on the sitcom and your whole family was alcoholics.
Yes.
But you are a survivor.
But I'm a survivor. Yes.
Anyway, let me just say something. And you were a victim of... Didn't your father rape you at a very young age?
Yes, yes. In fact, I don't know if you saw Lana Turner's daughter.
Yes.
Yeah, yes. Tarzan used to rape her,
yes,
she says.
Yes, oh!
Yeah. Lana Turner's daughter, who was the one who supposedly stabbed Johnny Stampinato.
Yes.
And now admits to being gay.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Lana Turner's daughter is gay.
I wonder why.
Didn't Cheetah rape her as well?
Yes.
Lana?
I think everyone in the jungle just took her.
Yeah, Jane raped her.
Yeah, Jane, Cheetah.
Sabu raped her. Just every major jungle person
Even
raped her.
Even the white guys who came into the jungle raped her.
The white guys who used to put on black makeup for extra work were raping her.
Boy had her.
Boy and Bamba.
Boy had her.
Rama had her.
Bamba
the
and...
The elephant.
And Jai had her, too.
Yes. So Lana Turner's daughter became a lesbian. I don't think that's any great shock when you have to go around stabbing your wife's husband.
No, what?
I mean, your mother's husband. I don't think that comes as any great shock that you might be hostile to men.
I just stabbed my mother's husband, and boy, is my arm tired. But you know...
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
You know, I don't even remember picking up the knife.
Yes. So let's review. Gilbert will be at Caroline's at the Seaport.
Yes. Gilbert Gottfried will be at the Seaport.
Lana Turner was raped by Tarzan.
No, Lana Turner's daughter.
Was raped by Tarzan.
Was raped by Tarzan.
Yes.
Cheetah.
Cheetah.
Gunja and Rama.
And Sabu.
And Sabu and Boy.
And
yeah.
Boy.
Okay,
yes.
That's it.
Bamba, mister?
Gilbert, the sensitive side of Gilbert Gottfried has just requested James Taylor.
Ah.
Yeah, because I'd like to just kind of sit and...
Relax.
Just no Jimmy.
Yes. I'm so glad he went bald. He was a little too good looking.
He was cute, wasn't
he? Yeah.
Oh, he was adorable.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. All right, 1025, 92.3
K-Rock. How many teeth does Carly Simon really have?
Well, why don't we wait till the next show to answer
that? Yeah. Okay. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Wait a second.
Yes.
That didn't sound very professional.
No, it didn't.
Oh, that sounds much better. Oh, much better.
Here we go. No problem.
Okay.
Here we go. And thanks for coming on, Gilbert.
No problem.
Here it is.
Oh, that's touching.
So sensitive.
You could kind of just, you know, just, you know, everyone in his family was an alcoholic.
Suzanne, and the dreams you made put an end to me. And wasn't he a heroin addict as well?
Yes, he was a heroin addict. Everyone in his family is a heroin addict.
Yes.
And he's a survivor, though.
Yes.
Because they changed his character on his last sitcom.
Yes.
Jimmy and Me.
Just yesterday morning.
Do you know for a fact this was yesterday?
We're gone.
Suzanne, the plans they made.
Does Carly Simon get cavities in those teeth?
Oh, I think they send people in to drill them. They send in entire troops on ropes to drill her teeth. It's like with power drills.
Exactly. Exactly.
Exactly.
Exactly.
Exactly. You know, her whole family are singers.
Yes.
And they're all alcoholics.
Yes.
Oh, no. We don't
but they're survivors.
He's doing comedy, though. It's not true.
Okay. It's not true, folks.
Listen,
not true.
We'll see you tomorrow.
That's like when you go on the Merv Griffin. Not true.
Not true.
Folks. Not true.
Just kidding.
Not true. Hi. Hi. Gilbert Gottfried for Ford. You know. Hi. Gilbert Gottfried here for Texaco.
All right, Gilbert. We got to go, man. I know.
Yeah, you could do comedy.
Hi. Gilbert Gottfried for James Taylor. Hi.
You got to help me.
He's on.
I'm letting go.
Yeah. Hi. Gilbert Gottfried here for the Howard Stern Show.
All right, we'll see you tomorrow.
Hi, Gilbert Gottfried here.
Doesn't Jackie Mason sing this song?
Well, you know, this is not against James Taylor as a person or Gilbert Gottfried way.